We continue our reading of From the Heart, a daily devotional by author Ellen G. White. Today's reading, January 16, The Power of Prayer. You will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you. Isaiah 26, verse 3. Prayer to the great physician for the healing of the soul brings the blessing of God. Prayer unites us, one to another, and to God. Prayer brings Jesus to our side and gives new strength and fresh grace to the fainting, perplexed soul. By prayer, the sick have been encouraged to believe that God will look with compassion upon them. A ray of light penetrates to the hopeless soul and becomes a savor of life unto a life. Prayer has subdued kingdoms, wrought righteousness, obtained promises, stopped the mouths of lions, quenched the violence of fire. We shall know what this means when we hear the reports of the martyrs who died for their faith, turned to flight the armies of the aliens. We shall hear about these victories when the captain of our salvation, the glorious King of Heaven, opens the record before those of whom John writes. These are they which came out of great tribulation and have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Christ, our Savior, was tempted in all points like as we are, yet he was without sin. He took human nature, being made in fashion as a man, and his necessities were the necessities of mankind. Prayer went before and sanctified every act of his ministry. He communed with his Father till the close of his life, and when he hung upon the cross, there arose from his lips the bitter cry, "My God, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" Then, in a voice which has reached to the very ends of the earth, he exclaimed, "Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit." The night seasons of prayer, which the Savior spent in the mountain or in the desert, were essential to prepare him for the trials he must meet in the days to come. All things are possible to those that believe. No one coming to the Lord in sincerity of heart will be disappointed. How wonderful it is that we can pray effectually, that unworthy, erring mortals possess the power of offering their requests to God. We utter words that reach the throne of the monarch of the universe. Review and Herald, October 30, 1900. This concludes our reading today of From the Heart. We realize that all our needs are in Jesus, and as the song says, "You are my all in all."
As a precious jewel, Lord, to give up, might be a fool. You are my all in all. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. So worthy, taking my sin, my cross, my shame, rising again, I bless your name. You are my all in all. When I fall down, you pick me up. And when I am dry, you fill my cup. You are my all in all. Oh, Jesus, Lamb of God.
Your name.